Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing great. I am Sohini Biswas, a third year law student, and currently I am doing an internship at the Lexis & Company. Today I am here and I'll be discussing on the topic of women's rights before marriages. So let us begin. There are several laws in India that give women the authority to fight against abuse, discrimination, harassment, violence and indignities, etc. Being aware of them is the first step towards fighting any kind of injustice. Women's agency and their independence have been stifled for a way too long. Now let us understand the legal rights of women in India. First, women have the right to equal pay. According to the provision listed under the Equal Remuneration Act, one cannot be discriminated on the basis of sex when it comes to salary, pay or wages. Working women have the right to draw an equal salary as compared to men. Second, women have the right to dignity and decency. In an event that the accused is a woman, any medical examination procedure on her must be performed by or in any presence of women. Third, women have the right against workplace harassment. The Sexual Harassment of Women at Workplace Act gives a female the right to file a complaint against any kind of sexual harassment at her place of work. Under this act, she can submit the written complaint to an Internal Complaint Committee, ICC, at a branch office within a period of 3 months. Next is the women have the right against domestic violence. Section 498 of the Indian Constitution looks to protect a wife, female, live-in partner or a woman living in a household like a mother or a sister from domestic violence, including verbal, economic, emotional and sexual by the hands of a husband, male, live-in partner or relative. The accused shall be punished with a non-bailable imprisonment for a term which may extend to 3 years and shall also be liable to fine. Fifth, female sexual assault victims have the right to keep their identity anonymous. To ensure that her privacy is protected, a woman who has been sexually assaulted may record her statement alone before the district magistrate when the case is under trial or in presence of a female police officer. Next is women have the right to get free legal aid. Under the Legal Services Authorities Act, female rape victims have the right to get free legal aid or help the legal service authority who has to arrange a lawyer for her. Next, women have right not to be arrested at night. Unless there is an exceptional case on the orders of a first-class magistrate, a woman cannot be arrested after sunset and before sunrise. In addition, the law also states that the police can interrogate a woman at her residence only in the presence of a woman constable and family members or friends. Next is the women have the right to register virtual complaints. The law gives women the provision for filing virtual complaints via email or writing her complaint and sending it to a police station from a registered postal address. Further, the SHO sends a police constable to her place to record her complaint. This is the case a woman is not in position to physically go to a police station and file a complaint. Next is women have the right against indecent representation. Depiction of a woman's figure, her form or any body part in any manner that is indecent, derogatory or is likely to deprave, corrupt or injure the public morality or moral is a punishable offense. Women have the right against being stalked. Section 354D of the IPC makes a way of legal action to be taken against an offender if he or she follows a woman, tries to contact her to foster personal interaction repeatedly despite a clear indication of disinterest, or monitor the use of a woman of interest on internet, email or any other form of electronic communication. Next is the women have a right to zero FIR. An FIR that can be filed at any police station irrespective of the location where the indecent occurrence or a specific jurisdiction it comes under. The zero FIR can later be moved to the police station in whose jurisdiction the case was under. This ruling was passed by the Supreme Court to save the victim's time and prevent an offender from getting way caught free. The Indian perspective regarding women is more clearly explained by the Supreme Court in various judgments. These judgments reflect the women's strength. Each of these judgments should be viewed as a thrust of a woman to reassert her strength to redefine the patriarchal laws. They show how a woman succeeds in being the voice of thousands of women, how they step up as a woman and took the lead. There are numerous judgments of the Supreme Court of India, but only a few are mentioned. First is the case of Vishakha and others versus the state of Rajasthan. The Supreme Court decided that The consideration of international conventions and norms are significant for the purpose of interpretation of the guarantee of gender equality, right to work with human dignity in Article 14, 15, 19, Clause 1, G and 21 of the Constitution. It safeguards against sexual harassment implicit therein. The petition resulted in what are popularly known as the Vishakha guidelines. The judgment provided the basic definition of sexual harassment at the workplace and provided guidelines to deal with it. It is seen as a significant legal victory for women's group in India. Article 14 and 15 of Indian Constitution provides provision for women. Now, what is the conclusion? Gender equality is fundamental to accelerate sustainable development. It is necessary to conduct gender analysis to identify sex and gender-based difference. Ending violence against women and girls is the primary mandate of the UN Women. UN Women works to make private and public spaces safer for women and girls through prevention, support and advocacy and facilitate youth-led solutions and actions. Thank you.